Good morning, children. So far, you have learned about the topics of factors and finding their common factors. Today, we are going to start a very interesting topic related to your previous ones, that is the highest common factor or HCF. If you find the common factors of two or more given numbers and then take out the common among the highest common factor among them, that factor is called highest common factor or simply HCF. Let us here look with the help of one example. Let us find the highest common factor of 12 and 16. We have the two numbers 12 and 16. First of all, we have to write the factors of 12. I hope you know how to find the factors of 12 now. The factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Then we have to write the factors of 16, and the factors of 16 are 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. Now, if you find the common factors between factors of 12 and 16, we find that the common factors are 1, 2, and 4. These are the common factors of 12 and 16. Now the last step, if we take the highest among all these common factors, that will become the highest common factor. Now you can clearly see the highest common factor among these three numbers is 4. Therefore, HCF of 12 and 16 is equal to 4. Now let us come to another example in which we have to find HCF of three numbers 15, 25 and 30. So let us first of all find the factors of 15. Factors of 15 are 1, 3, 5 and 15. The second number is 25. Factors of 25 are 1, 5 and 25. And factors of 30 are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. These are the factors of the given numbers. Now, next step, find the common factors first of all. The common factors we see, they are 1 is appearing in all the three numbers, then 5. And there is no other common factor among all the factors of the given three numbers. Now, the last step, we have to take the highest of the common factors. And clearly, the highest of the common factors is 5. Therefore, HCF of 15, 25 and 30 is 5. Now children, the last two examples in which we have found out the HCF of the two given numbers or three given numbers, we have used the method of factor method. Now there is one another method from which we can find the highest common factor. That method is called the division method. Now we learn how to find out the HCF of two or more numbers using division method. Now the first example is we have to find the HCF of 8 and 12. As from the name, it is clear that it is carried out using division of two given numbers. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to take 12 inside the division box because it is greater of a two number and make 8 as the divisor. 12 becomes the divided and 8 becomes the divisor. Now in the table of 8, you have to check where does 12 comes or smaller than that. 8 ones are is 8. And if you subtract it, the answer is 4. Now children, look this bit very carefully. The remainder now will become the divisor. And the divisor which was earlier, that is 8, becomes the dividend. You have to carry out division again. Keeping in mind, the remainder after first division step becomes the divisor. And the 8 that was earlier the divisor becomes the dividend. Now you have to check in the table of 4, where does 8 comes? It comes at 4 and you are left with no remainder. You have to carry on this division till your remainder becomes 0. Now as children the remainder is 0, you have to stop it. Now the HCF will be that divisor due to which the remainder becomes 0. And the divisor we have got it as 4. Therefore, the HCF of 8 and 12 is equal to 4. Now let us carry out one more example through division method. The two numbers are 30 and 42, from in which we have to find their highest common factor. Now what we are going to do is, I am going to use the division method, 42 inside and 30 outside. In the table of 30, we do not have 42, yes, but a number less than that. 30 ones is 30 and the remainder is 12. Now children, this remainder 12 now becomes the divisor and 30 becomes the dividend. Again, we have to check the table of 12, where this 30 comes. Actually, it does not come in the table of 12, so we have to take a number lesser than that. 12 2s are 24. And if you subtract, still the remainder is left. Then we are going to follow the same step again until our remainder becomes 0. Now, 6 will become the divisor and the earlier divisor will become the dividend, that is 12. Now you can clearly see 6 2s are is 12 and you are left with no remainder. So as told you earlier, the divisor through which the remainder is 0 will become the HCF of the 2 or more given numbers. Therefore, HCF is equal to 6. Now we are going to continue with the division method, but now you can see there are 3 numbers to find the HCF. And 3 numbers are 12, 45 and 75. Now in this case, when 3 numbers are there, you are going to take 2 numbers at a time. And it is your choice which numbers you are going to take. Now here I am going to first of all take 12 and 45 and then take their HCF through division method. 45 and 12 becomes the divisor. Now in the table of 12 we have 3s are 36 and if we subtract the remainder is 9. So we are going to repeat our steps again. 9 becomes the divisor, 12 becomes the dividend, the earlier divisor. 9 1s are 9, again a remainder 3 is left. Then again the step, 3 is the divisor, 9 becomes the dividend. Now 3 3s are is 9, with we are left with no remainder. Therefore, when we have taken pair of 12 and 45, our HCF is coming out to be 3. So you write HCF of the first two numbers 12 and 45 is equal to 3. Now children, you are still left with a number that is 75. Now what you are going to do is, the HCF that you have got earlier of the two numbers will be taken with the leftover number 75 and we will proceed with the division method once again. So what I am going to do is, 75 is to be divided by the HCF of the earlier two numbers, that is 3. Now you know that 3, first of all 3 2s are 6. Now this is a continued division only. And 5 is 15. You are left with 0 remainder. This is a complete one step. Now, due to 3, the remainder of, if you divide 75 by 3, the remainder is 0. So the HCF of all the 3 numbers will be taken as 3. Hence, we have got the answer. HCF of 12, 45 and 75 is coming out to be 3. Now let us take one more example, how to find HCF through division method of three numbers, 91, 112 and 49. Now children, you can take the numbers in any order, whatever you feel like easy. I am taking 91 and 112 first. First of all, we are going to find the HCF of 91 and 112. 112 inside and 91 outside, that becomes the divisor. Now in the table of 91, we have only 1s are 91 and the remainder is 21. As you are left with the remainder, you are going to proceed further with the same steps. 21 and 91 we are going to divide, and if you see 21 4s are is 84, and if you subtract, the remainder is 7. So again we are going to follow the same steps. 7 outside, 21 becomes the dividend, and 7 3s are is 21 with no remainder left. So the divisor due to which the remainder becomes 0 is the HCF. HCF of the first two numbers, that is 91 and 112, is 7. Now this HCF will be used to divide the left over the third number, that is 49. So we are going to have division of 49 and 7. 49 becomes the dividend and 7 becomes the divisor. 7 7s are is 49, and this is the number due to which the remainder is 0 on division with 49, on division of 49 with 7. Therefore, the complete HCF of the three numbers 91, 112 and 49 is equal to 7. So children, here you have learned how to find the HCF, that is the highest common factor of two or more numbers, using two methods. The factor method and division method. And you can use any of these two methods, whichever you feel like easy and comfortable with. One more thing, there is another name for the highest common factor. It is also known as the greatest common divisor, because you know factors are the exact divisors of a number. So the other name for HCF is also GCD, that is the greatest common divisor. Thank you and have a nice day.